So guys, welcome to the debrief, another episode after a brilliant win against Nottingham Forest. I'm delighted to be joined by Mickey van der Ven. Mickey, how are you?
Yeah, good, how are you?
I'm very good, thank you. Great to have you here. It was only right that we brought you into the debrief after that fantastic goal. But not only the goal, it was a brilliant performance from you and the team. I want to start though at half-time, because we went into half-time at 1-1. So, as we see some of the scenes from that half-time period, talk to me a little bit about what Ange said to you guys at halftime.
I think we started the game quite well, and we controlled the game, and then they scored the equalizer.
Yep.
So then afterwards we lost the control a bit, and I don't think it was really stress or something, but we lost the control a bit, and then as you can see, Rodri and Pierre came on, and I think they had a great impact on us on the midfield. Of course, Biss and Papa did their job also well.
Yeah.
But they brought some new energy, and I think we showed more running distance and more hard work in the second half, and I think we controlled the whole game.
Of course. I mean, we used to see in that huddle at the very start of the game. So what did Sonny say at halftime? Because obviously we've heard a bit about what Ange just said.
What Sonny said in the circle?
Yeah.
So I have to think, to be honest. But no, it was like, just do our job, and if we keep playing like our way, like how we always do, I think we will create some more chances, and I think we will get the 3 points staying in our stadium.
So Mickey, we did exactly that. Let's take a look at your goal, because you were a vital part of our victory. Now, I'm used to seeing Sonny, maybe Deki, Timo strike balls so sweetly, but look at you here, the power that you got on there. Talk to me about that finish.
I stepped back and I saw I had the space in front of my left feet, and I was just waiting for Sonny to pass the ball to me, and the good thing Sonny did is he waited, so the defenders came more to him, so it created more space for me, and at the moment when I touched the ball, I looked up quick and I saw the short corner was open, and I was just like, now it's just shoot it as hard as possible in the short corner, and I think I hit it quite well and it went in.
Quite well, you could say that, mate, you could say that. Talk to me about, is this something you do in training? Do you practice these shots, or is this something that just happened in the moment, organically?
No, we as defenders, we don't train our finishing in the training. But I don't know, I hit it well, and it was an amazing feeling.
Very, very sweet. Best goal of your career so far?
Yeah.
Come on, Mickey, that's what we like to see. Well, let me take you down to our floor graphic here, because in true debrief style, I have got your goal. Now, what we can see is this lovely bit of work down this right-hand side. The ball comes to Sonny. He does a couple of step-overs and lays it off to you. In the moment when Sonny receives the ball, what's going through your head at that moment? Because, we're used to seeing you at the back here, kind of covering with your pace at the back, but you are up in a striker's position. So were you already thinking, if the ball comes to me, I shoot? Or what was going through your mind?
Yeah, I saw that I had some space to touch the ball and to shoot. And what I said before, it was what Sonny did well is he waited with the ball, so the defenders came to him, so it created more space for me. And at the moment he passed the ball to me, I was straight like, okay, I touch it now and I shoot.
Yeah. Brilliantly brought onto the left foot as well, always going in the top bins as soon as you hit that. It was absolutely beautiful. Something else we see, I talked about your goal, we've talked about the finish, was also covering at the back. And there was a brilliant moment of fan appreciation when you outpaced Callum Hudson-Odoi. So we're going to take a quick look at that now. But we see the ball just deflects up, gets put forward by Forrest, and here's you. It's that trademark Mickey van der Ven pace. There is no striker who will outpace you, Mickey. I'm saying it right now. Fastest player in the Premier League. But talk to me about that moment, because we see here there's loads of fan appreciation for that.
What you saw before, the ball struggled a bit. I think Guti did quite well. They were a bit lucky with the ball coming straight to them.
Yeah.
And we knew already from the meetings that they, for the counter-attack, they straight look for the long balls. And I saw Hudson-Odoi sprinting already, and I knew already that Gibbs White was going to play it.
Mm.
So the moment he played it, I saw the space ready for where he was probably going to play it. So I run already, and then I was in front of Hudson-Odoi. Yeah, I think we defended well.
Definitely. What's it like to get a reception like that during a game? Because we see full-time scenes and fans celebrating at the very end, but during a game when a moment like that happens and there's a ripple around the stadium, that must be a special feeling.
Yeah, it is. But to be honest, you're not really focusing on it because you're really focused on the game straight away. So you defend the action and yeah, the game keeps going. So it's not the moment that I can really enjoy what the fans are doing. Of course, I appreciate it. You hear it, but it's not that you're really focused on it.
Yeah, yeah. Well, let me take you into full-time scenes because not only did we see you guys celebrating on the pitch, we saw the fans celebrating. And one thing that they particularly love is to sing your name, Mickey van der Ven. We love the song, right? We see fans out in the stadium with signs. Look, here we go.
Yeah.
You know, celebrating you. How does it feel to feel the love of the fans, you know, so early in your Spurs career?
Yeah, it feels amazing. I really appreciate the love I get from the fans. And that's the main thing. I really appreciate it, what they're doing. I love it when they sing my name. Of course, you see here with
your teammates,
with Timo. They always sing it. To be honest, the players in the dressing room are always singing it to
Do
me.
Do they?
Yeah. Like Richie or Emmet, they're always singing it. So yeah, I really appreciate how the fans love me. And hopefully we can give them some special moments back.
Yes, absolutely brilliant. Well, all of us Spurs fans are absolutely loving you, Mickey. So thank you for all the effort
that
you've put in so far this season. It's not done yet. We've got Newcastle up next. How are you feeling ahead of that one?
I think it's a big game, a difficult game. Newcastle away is always a difficult game. But I think if we play our game and we do what we have to do, that we can get the 3 points.
Yes, love to hear it, Mickey. Optimism. Love that. Thank you so much for joining us here on The Debrief. And we will see you guys next time.